By 2030, Oslo is expected to cut its greenhouse gas emissions by up to 95%, probably making it one of the first emission-free capitals in the world. It's almost as if Oslo has become the world's test lab for climate technology. The way to become emission-free is to go electric, and this is how it's done in Oslo. Hi there, I'm Paul from Norway. And when you walk around in Oslo, you basically see electrical vehicles everywhere. Electrical car, electrical car, electrical car, electrical car, electrical car, electrical car, electrical car. In 2022, 80% of all the cars that were sold in Oslo were electric. And the goal is that by 2025, that number should be up to 100%. A lot of incentives have been offered to people, triggering them to go electric. Not all of them are still in effect, but a few of them still are. These incentives include no VAT on cars worth under 500,000 kroner, no emissions tax, reduced prices on parking, and you pay less road tolls. One advantage of having an electric car is that if you are two or more in the car together, like me and my cameraman right now, then you can drive in the public transport lane.
In Norway, there are more than 5,000 charging stations, with a fair amount of them being spread out all over Oslo. In other words, you're never far away from a charging station when you need to top up the battery. Actually, if you set up a parking house or a parking lot today, you're required to install chargers, and landlords can get funding for making them available in private garages.
Having a good charging infrastructure is, of course, very important if you want people to buy an electrical car. And I think the Norwegian government has done a very good job in making it the obvious choice. And one of the biggest advantages, perhaps, comes in a place like this, when you charge rather than fill. In Oslo, for getting around, about 30% use a car, 40% walk, 7% use a bike, and 22% ride public transport.
Oslo got a great public transportation system with trams, buses, metro, trains and ferries. They're fast, reliable and environmentally friendly.
The tram, or the trikk as we call it in Norway, is fully electric, and in Oslo it carries up to 50 million passengers a year.
The metro, or T-bane as we call it, is also fully electric, and over 40% of all public transport in Oslo takes place on it.
Same goes for the ferries going out to the islands, 100% electric. They charge here at the docks and then they're good to go for a 1 hour round trip.
Even the buses, like the one I'm on now, are going electric. And within a year or two, all of them are going to be emission free.
So as one of the first capitals in the world, soon Oslo's public transport will run 100% on electricity. Another way of cutting greenhouse gas emissions is to let transportation and heavy vehicles run on electricity, because this sector emits 13% of the greenhouse gases in Oslo today.
The goal for Oslo is that all heavy vehicles will run on electricity or biogas by 2030. However, in 2022, only 37% of newly sold vehicles of this type satisfy this criteria. So how can they achieve this goal? To give incentives to companies to invest in these vehicles, the Oslo municipality has promised free road tolls for these vehicles at least until 2027. If you're a business, the city of Oslo will cover up to 80% of your costs putting up a charging station. It's crucial to have these stations, so that heavy vehicles don't have to line up together with private vehicles. I should also add that if you're a business and want to buy an electric van or a small truck, you can get up to 50,000 kroner in support from the state.
It's also fun to see more and more of these delivery vehicles going electric. I just love that Oslo is going electric. The city has become so much more cleaner and peaceful. And we should also not forget about these electrical scooters. They're basically everywhere.